God. What the hell is this? Stop. No. Velvet?
EA Sports coverage of the NFL break tab between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Cleveland Browns. Coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Green Bay Packers. Kicker Jake Elliott ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lambeau. Keyshawn Nixon now from his end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Instead, it's second down.
Not the desired outcome, but probably won't be the last time we see him take a shot downfield.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Throwing now is Rodgers. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. Rodgers to throw for it on fourth. It finds Redd. Completion. And he's going to be out of bounds inside the 25-yard line. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And this ball incomplete. Looked very much to be a catchable ball and could not hang on. Second down coming up.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
To throw once more on second and 10. Rodgers. That's a Packers touchdown. Aaron Rodgers hitting Alan Lazard. And the Packers are on the board first here this afternoon. Well, they spoke about the importance of getting off to a good start, and they're on their first drive, Charles, into the end zone for the touchdown.
And what an advantage for them. They're already clicking one drive in, didn't need to wait to get up to full speed. We had heard about the extra time they put in with each other, trying to learn each other's skills, what they like, the whole deal. And it paid off early in this one. I would expect them to keep firing on the next drive and keep that connection going.
And he will get in to make it 8-0. Interesting. I mean, they're putting their foot on the gas here early, going for two to go up 8-0.
Well, after that drive, you have to believe that they thought to themselves, if we can do that, what's another 2 yards? Let's go get those and get 2 points as a result.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This one complete down the field to Goddard. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A gain of 32 that time. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Hurts. Man open left side is Brown. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A.J. Brown, 43 yards. And the Eagles have cut the lead back down to two. Well, Charles, here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. That looked like a well-designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon. A player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Nixon now from his end zone. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit with that old expression we love to use, time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
No surprise at all. They're looking for the big man early in this one. The only surprise for them, he couldn't hang on to the pass.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. To throw is Rodgers. He'll find DeGuara complete. And he's going to have a Packers first down. And he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and two.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out, didn't give him a cutback lane. On each play, you have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse. They played that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of bounds. And he'll let this go deep for Lazard. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that. Well, that would have been a big play. But he could not pull it in.
Well, that play there was certainly a scouting report special because coverage was all too aware that this close to the end zone, he's going to become a bigger weapon for that offense. And they were there to help force the incompletion.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And that will be incomplete.
And I feel like my man, Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
It's Rodgers, and it's going to be batted down, and we'll go the other way with the football. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it, and that will force a turnover on downs. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory, and you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right, the social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room? Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe some explanations.
It's a loss of four on the first down play.
I think we have to give all the credit to the defense there. Very disciplined in their approach. Never allowed a cutback lane, which was exactly what he was looking for. They end up forcing him out of bounds for a loss.
So the first play of the drive, loss four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Throwing is Hurts. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Javondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks it. And the Packers are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
Oh, this is a great play right here by a very versatile linebacker. It's a zone defense, so he's responsible for one area of the field. And Brandon, I don't think the quarterback ever saw it. Or if he did, he saw him too late because he snuck into a great position there to pick that one off.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Last time out, Charles, and now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Packers. Two touchdown passes now here in this first quarter for Aaron Rodgers. And the Packers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. So now Rodgers will lead the Packers up to go for two. Rodgers will throw for it. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Well, split the difference, and they're right where they would have been with two PATs. They got the two-point conversion the first time. They failed there.
Interesting, isn't it? Because the first time you go after your first score, that feels like a gamble. The second time when they tried it again, that felt like, what the heck, right? Because, as you said, even if you miss it, you split the difference, and you're right on schedule at 14 points.
Offense set to begin their next drive. Been a little bit of an interesting start. The first drive for him, Charles, they had the passing touchdown. The second drive, he threw the interception. So we'll see what this third drive of the ball game brings.
Yeah, it's kind of a tiebreaker, isn't it? I mean, that's a tough part for them and for him because, yeah, things went really well in that first one, not so well on the second one. He wants to get back to what he did to get this game going.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
First down with Hurts. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Another big gainer, two in succession, as this one goes for 32. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Now Sanders. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. Ouch, could have been a game-tying touchdown. They'll have to hold on that at least for now.
Ouch in a big way, like ripping the Band-Aid off there. Can they let the sting subside and come back and get it done?
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. Motion right is Watkins. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. So the completion good for seven there. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's got Watkins on the out route. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. So certainly not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on fourth.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise, they keep their confidence. Just because it didn't work once doesn't mean if they get that same situation later that they shouldn't go for it again. The defense feels great, but the offense, they can't be despondent.
Rodgers now on first down. He'll find Lazard here over the middle. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that will bring up second down. We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Throwing again on second down, Rodgers. And Lazard's got it again. And he'll be dropped at the 36. It's a good gain of 18 on a play that originated back at the 18. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down.
Come on.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. And he'll let this go deep for Lazard. And this is taken in at the 5. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 42 yards. What a first half this has been offensively. I mean, defensively, what do you do when you're getting torched like this?
Now, these receivers are absolutely wearing them out. So two thoughts come to mind. One, get some oxygen. You can fill up your lungs a little bit. And number two, talk to your guys up.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Hassan Reddick. And the Eagles are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. But turnovers, obviously, Charles, always costly. But, man, when you throw those interceptions in the end zone like that, it really stings.
He tried to fit that one into his tight end. And I often use the expression NFL open, which means a tighter window. Down near the goal line, you really want him to be open. In this case, it cost him.
From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. Hurts to throw. And this is caught. It's Brown. A big play there just before halftime. And even 40 yards. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Sets up to throw it. This is Smith with a grab. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Devontae Smith as the first half is winding down. And the Eagles have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
Good with a PAT, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Well, on that one, they go with a play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You've got to sell the run action. Otherwise, why do you stop at the running back? You just run straight for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Hurts a handoff to Sanders. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
50 bites, 50 bites.
Second down, back to Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, a 12-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles have moved out in front. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up. Meaning, when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Now, after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Nixon now from his end zone. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Well, Charles, you and I said in intermission, feels like we're set up for a good second half. Well, the other side scored. Now it's up to them to answer. How do they respond here with their first drive of the second half?
Well, bottom line is they just saw the ball go in the end zone against their defense, and they saw what good offense looks like. They believe they've got a good offense as well. From the best plays you've got to the top performers you have, and try to move that ball down the field for an answering score.
Charles, that was a heck of a play.
It truly was, because when he made that catch,
he had to shake through some people, right? So that play, to me, a highlight film that should be accompanied by bass music, right? I mean, boom, 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 and he finds his way to the end zone. Terrific play.
And this will be caught as they convert here for two. Touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. Well, not one you see often there as he fails to keep it between the sidelines, and that is a penalty every time and going to give this offense better field position.
And it's every kickoff guy's nightmare, isn't it? Because you don't see yourself doing this, and most of the time you don't. It's absolutely a miss hit, and now your team pays the price. Bad field position for your defense.
Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved. A false start backs him up five. First and 15.
19, driver, 19, driver.
He'll look to throw. And that's caught inside the 35. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. And that one results in 35 yards.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other with each additional play.
Running right, here's Sanders. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Second down, back to Sanders. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meets had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Out route pass complete to Goddard. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. Hurts finding Goddard there. First down, Philadelphia.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
You can just kind of sense the momentum turning here. It's first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Watkins. Touchdown, Eagles! Quez Watkins from 13 yards out. And the Eagles have retaken a third quarter lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Elliott on for the extra point. And that'll make this a six-point game.
Makes the score Eagles 28, Packers 22.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Nixon now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped it to 23. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And Charles, the name of the game last time, efficiency. Their very first snap, they connected for a quick touchdown.
They get more value than just the points from that series as well. Only needing one play, it keeps the entire offense rested up.
On play action, it's Rodgers. He'll let this go deep for Lazard. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown! Alan Lazard with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Packers have tied the ball game with a chance to go ahead now in the final seconds of the third quarter.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the podcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
They'll look to throw, and that is caught for the 2 points. So both offenses come to life here in this third quarter as this is shaping up for a good finish. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Beyond now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. But first down, Hurts. And he rifles one incomplete. Quez Watkins, the intended target. That'll bring up second down.
He could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
In motion left goes Smith.
19-18.
On second and 10, Hurts. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Hurts. Packer pressure and down he goes. They could not contain Kenny Clark as he gets home for the sack.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the, so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they? A dime? What were they?
About 15 cents.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Going deep here for Watkins. They got his man complete. Touchdown, Eagles. Quez Watkins, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead.
Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead is up to five. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Nixon now from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21.
Offense ready to get their next drive underway. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter. Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Based on the play we just saw there, he might not be the guy you want to challenge in coverage on these all-important snaps. He certainly looks dialed in right now.
Under four to go now as they come up on second down. Here's Rodgers to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And